God, we are here once again today. And actually, it's an everyday deal. We all think of our brave young men and women who gave their lives to fight for this great country of ours and were not able to come home. I also want to give special thanks today to the Cub Scouts and the Boy Scouts of the town of Raymond. They are the ones who placed the flags on the veterans' graves, and they did a wonderful job. So Lord, keep those young men able to do that duty. It's a very good duty. And please keep remembering our fallen comrades and the families they left behind. Thank you very much, God. Amen.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Raymond, New Hampshire on Memorial Day. Welcome to Raymond, New Hampshire on Memorial Day. It is my great honor to introduce Randy LaCasse and the Raymond High School Band with the national anthem. If everyone could please stand at attention while they play the national anthem. Thank you, Raymond High School Band. Let me now introduce Amanda, who's going to lead us in our invocation.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we're gathered here today to honor and remember our men and women of the armed forces who have paid the ultimate price for us and our country. Because of their sacrifice, we live in freedom and safety. Help us all to show their families how grateful we are, not just today, and every day. May your promised everlasting peace come real soon to the home, the land of the free, because of the brave. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you.
Check 1, 2. It's a great honor to be here today. It's a very special day. It's the day that all Americans honor those who are no longer with us. This isn't about the barbecues. This isn't about the family get-togethers. It's about the people who made our country so great. It's about honoring them. Raymond has a deep tradition in this. We're assembled here at the Common. We have a wonderful memorial going back to the end of the Civil War. There's many names on that. I'd like for, if you all haven't had a chance to, if you can go by and read all the names on the monument right here in the Common. Many of those names have relatives that are here today on the Common with us. Very, very deep tradition of military here in Raymond. And I'm just honored to be able to be here to remember these guys. Everybody here has a connection with Raymond and the military. A year ago, we didn't have quite the turnout we do today. This is a wonderful turnout. Hopefully we can get it even bigger next year. Again, thank you for coming out and honoring those people in the military that are near and dear to you and those comrades that all of us have. Thank you. Thank you. At this time, I'd like to present the commander of the VFW here in Raymond, Ray Marotte.
Today we're gathered here in remembrance of the men and women who gave their lives in our nation's defense. They paid the highest price for our freedom, along with their people being held as prisoners of war and the people missing in action. There are also the widows and children of these men and women and their loved ones who paid dearly for their loss. All these people on this day should be remembered. Thank you.
Again, welcome to Raymond. My name is Craig Wheeler, and I'm the town manager, and I have a few thoughts regarding today's event. In 1764, 250 years ago, this town was founded, and it continues to this day. 146 years ago, on May 5th, in 1868, General Joshua Logan, in his capacity as Commander-in-Chief of the Grand Army of the Republic, which was the Veterans Organization for Union Civil War Veterans, issued a proclamation calling for Decoration Day. Today, Decoration Day. It was to be observed annually and nationwide. From our beginnings in 1764 to 1868, a total of 104 years, we did not collectively honor our friends, neighbors, and relatives who served our community. From 1868 to 1910, a period of 42 years, residents, friends, and neighbors celebrated Decorations Day to honor the memory of the loyal sons and daughters who served in the war to preserve the Union. What was significant about 1910? Well, on Tuesday, June 21st in 1910, with more than 3,000 people attending this event, the monument situated in the middle was erected and dedicated to the loyal, to the memory of the soldiers and sailors who served in the war. On the three sides are inscribed the names of various Raymond men, women, and families. Daniel Batchelder, Daniel Bean, William Green, George John and Orrin Cram, many, many others. Please pause and take a look at their names. Raymond furnished 187 soldiers to that crisis. 30 were killed and died in service. From 1868 until today, a period of 140 years, residents of this proud town have gathered together to pay respect and remembrance to the loyal sons and daughters who have paid the ultimate sacrifice for this community, this state, and our nation. On this Memorial Day, we pause to reflect upon our blessings as a nation and the high cost of those blessings for many. We thank for the freedom we enjoy in this country, for opportunities to flourish, and for the security of our land. We thank those who have served in our armed services of our country, risking their lives for our liberty. And we thank those who have given their lives in their service to our country, sacrificing in such a costly way for the sake of others. Today, day set apart, not just for celebration, but for solemn remembrance as we consider the sacrifices of so many in our military. May we become more aware of just how blessed we are as a nation. May we be more grateful for our blessings, more faithful in our stewarding, and more eager to share them with others. It's now my honor to introduce Wayne Welch, Chairman of the Board of Selectmen, who has a few words and who will introduce the remaining selectmen. Thank you all for attending today. With us on the bandstand today is Colleen Westcoast, Greg Amos, and Frank Wheeler, Jack Barton. I want to thank them for marching today. Memorial Day, originally called Decoration Day, is the day we honor and remember those soldiers who gave their lives preserving our nation. More than 1 million men and women gave their lives in service to this country. This day, unlike Veterans Day, we honor our fallen soldiers. I'd like to read a poem by Kelly Strong called "Freedom Is Not Free." I watched the flag pass by one day, it fluttered in the breeze. A young Marine saluted it, and then he stood at ease. I looked at him in uniform, so young, so tall, so proud. He stands out in any crowd. I thought how many men like him had fallen through the years, how many died on foreign soil, how many mothers' tears. How many pilots' planes shot down, how many died at sea, how many foxholes were soldiers' graves. No, freedom isn't free. I heard the sound of taps one night when everything was still. I listened to the bugler play and felt a sudden chill. I wondered just how many times that taps had been meant amen when a flag had draped a coffin of a brother or a friend. I thought of all the children, of the mothers and the wives, our fathers, sons, and husbands with interrupted lives. I thought about a graveyard at the bottom of the sea, of unmarked graves at Arlington. No freedom isn't free. I have memories as a child of past Memorial Days. I once asked my father why that car carrying those three ladies had a gold star on it. His reply, "Son, That is why we're here today, to share in honor and gratitude to those ladies. Their sons died while serving our nation. They are our Gold Star mothers. I will always remember them and still look to this day for that Gold Star. Raymond is a proud community. We have built three monuments, so we will always remember. In front of us stands the Civil War Memorial of 1910. Across the street is the World War I Memorial. And on that memorial, if you take the time to read, it reads, Dudley Gilmore Tucker, killed in action, July 8, 1918. Emerson Maple, killed in action, July 20th, 1918. Both died on foreign soil. Where we stand today, the Veterans Memorial Bandstands, lies the names of Herbert W. Brown, Kenneth L. Eccleston, Chris McCarrigan, Elmer Wheaton, Sartorius M. Margaritas, all who died while serving their nation. These soldiers of Raymond are never to be forgotten. It is our duty to honor and always remember them and what they stood for. It also falls upon us to teach our children and grandchildren what this Memorial Day stands for and that time will never pass it by. It is who we are and what we stand for that makes America great. It is our legacy to carry on and remember. We walked among the crosses where our fallen soldiers lay and listened to the bugle as taps began to play. The chaplains led a prayer, we stood with heads bowed low, and I thought of fallen comrades I had known so long ago. They came from every city across this fertile land that we might live in freedom. They lie there beneath the sand. I felt a little guilty, my sacrifice was small. I only lost a little time, but these men lost their all. Now the services are over for this Memorial Day. To the names upon those crosses, I just want to say, thank you for what you've given. No one could ask for more. May you rest with God in heaven from now through evermore. And that was by J.W. Johnson. Thank you.
Our final prayer will be given by John Barnes, followed by Taft. Thank you all for being here. Before I give the final prayer, I have something I'd like to read.
It's out of the last Veterans of Foreign Wars magazine, put together by the editors. And I think it's, I couldn't have said it any better. When I read this, I said, this has got to be said. From these honored dead, we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave the last full measure of devotion, that we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain. That was said by our great president, Abraham Lincoln, as part of his Gettysburg Address. It's a sacred day to all war veterans. None need to be reminded of the reason why Memorial Day must be commemorated. But what about the general public, and more importantly, future generations? Do most non-veterans really recognize the importance of May 30th? Judging from what Memorial Day has become, simply another day off from work, the answer is resounding no. Perhaps a reminder is due them. Then it is the duty of each and every veteran to relay the message. Why remember? Sacrifice is meaningless without remembrance. America's collective consciousness of demands that all citizens be aware of and recall on special occasions the deaths of their fellow countrymen during wartime. Far too often, the nation as a whole takes for granted the freedoms all Americans enjoy. Those freedoms were paid for with the lives of others of us who actually knew. That's why they are all collectively remembered on one special day. This should be regarded as a civic obligation. But this is a national debt that can only be truly repaid by individual Americans. By honoring the nation's war dead, we preserve their memory and thus their service and sacrifice. Who are we remembering?
The nation mourns the loss of all Americans who died defending their country throughout the world since 1775. These are men and women who will remain mostly anonymous except to the families who love them. They came from all walks of life and regions of the country, but they all had one thing in common: love and loyalty to our country. This bond cemented ties between them in times of trials, allowing the devised loss of Americans to achieve monumental ends. Who were they? They were relatives, friends, and neighbors melded together to perform a service for an entire society. They were the nation's defenders. Memorial Day is exclusively for honoring those who died serving in uniform during wartime. What are we remembering? We remember the loss of defenders, a sense of loss that takes group form. In essence, America is commemorating those who made the greatest sacrifice possible, giving one's own life selflessly. This remembrance is all-inclusive, spanning 239 years and some 62 military actions that claimed 1.2 million lives. Most Americans are familiar with the major wars: Revolutionary War, War of 1812, the Mexican War, the Civil War, the Spanish-American War, World War I and II, Korea, Vietnam, Persian Gulf, Iraq, and Afghanistan. But few think of those killed in minor frays. Examples of the lesser-known actions range from the Franco-American Naval War, 1798 to 1800, to the tragedy of the USS Cole in 2000. No American death is too insignificant to remember when that life was lost at the behest of society. GIs do not choose where they serve or what foreign policy they must enforce. The death of a sailor in the Persian Gulf is every bit as important as one killed in the Pacific during World War II. Such distinctions are irrelevant. Perhaps the most profound tribute of all was made on the first National Memorial Observance in May 1868 by then General James A. Garfield, when he said, "They summed up and perfected by one supreme act the highest virtues of men and citizens, the love of country. They accepted death and thus resolved all doubts and made immortal their patriotism and virtue." Thank you for listening, folks. Now I will give the closing prayer. For some reason, that thing doesn't want me to be back there. Let us pray. Almighty God, giver of all victories, we thank thee for the opportunities which abide in our land, for thy guidance in the hour of peril, and thy tender love in times of need. Help us to remember with reverence the valor and devotion of our departed comrades, not only those whose bodies consecrate our country's soil, but also those who sleep beyond the seas, and others whose resting places will not be known until that last day when the deep will have given up its dead. O God, teach us to honor them by ever cherishing the ideals for which they fought. Keep Americanism. Give us the power to see and the will to do right. Grant that the American Legion and all other veterans organizations give us the power to high ideals for which our comrades died. May thy merciful blessing rest upon those that are left behind. Keep us forever firm in righteousness, humble of heart, and unselfish in purpose. Amen.